This video is part of a larger video series where we are making Microsoft Word documents Section 508 compliance. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and thank you for joining me today. Font color passes color contrast ratio of at least 4.5 to 1. Now, this is an interesting thing to fix. The first thing that you're gonna wanna do is get a tool that can test color contrast ratios. My favorite is called the Color Contrast Analyzer, and it's made by a company called TPGI. I will include a link in the description of where you can download this tool for free. Now, let's make sure we have a couple of colors that are absolutely failing. We'll do like test one, test two, test three. And what we're looking for here is colors that fail. So clearly, yellow is going to fail. We might even have instances of light blue that'll fail. And let's take one more. Let's do a green. Now, you could do a low level visual test with your eyes to determine whether or not, like, is it hard to read? If so, it probably fails color contrast. So we're gonna take our color contrast analyzer and we're gonna test the foreground color. That is the font color. Currently, our background color is already set to white. And we can use this little eyedropper tool to select the font color. So I'm selecting my yellow on a background of white, and it currently has a contrast ratio of 1.1 to 1. That is abysmal. There are some things we can do. Obviously, we would need a darker color for it to pass, but in the color contrast analyzer, we have the ability to synchronize color values, and you can drag these little things around to try to find a color that is compliant. Now, because we're using yellow, we're not gonna find anything that's compliant for yellow on a white background. We could, however, put a black bar behind it and that would make it compliant. Let's see what else we can do. Let's take this yellow and we're gonna change it to maybe orange and then let's test that one. I think it's still gonna fail, but we're getting closer. We are now at 1.6. We need to get to 4.5. Let's try the synchronize option again. Nope, it's still not gonna let us do that. We can turn off the synchronize color value and we can start to adjust our colors here. And as I drag these sliders around, you can see the contrast ratio being updated. Now, yellow and orange are kind of challenging. Basically, what it's gonna come down to is we're gonna have to find a brown. That's like the only color that will pass. Is you have to go more brown. And that's for anytime you're using a white background. So let's test this this brown. It still doesn't pass. Let's see if we can find something better. See, it wants us to go green. You basically can use these sliders just to drag it around to find a color that will pass. And as it stands now, this is about as close as we're gonna get. So this foreground color, you can come in here, do a more colors option and update the hex and select okay, but it's brown. So yellow and orange just don't work on a white background. That's just the way that it is. Let's go ahead and run the accessibility checker from within Microsoft Word. File, info, check for issues, check accessibility. Interesting. I was hoping that it would pick up these other colors, but let's see if they actually fail. Sometimes Microsoft Word does a good job at finding these colors and other times it doesn't. So let's use the eyedropper tool and let's test this light blue. And it totally fails. So I'm actually surprised that Microsoft Word did not find this particular error. It could be that I need to save the document. Let's go ahead and save it. And let's see if that changes anything. We'll just run the scanner one more time. File, info, check for issues, check accessibility. Nope, it is not finding that as an error. So this is a perfect example of how we cannot rely on the Microsoft Word accessibility checkers for compliance. Let's test this green one out, and that one fails too, 1.7 to 1. So what we need to do is update these colors. I'm gonna take this light blue, and instead of doing the light blue, I'm gonna go to the darkest blue that is offered in the drop-down list. Same with this green, I'm gonna do the darkest green, and I believe both of those should pass. So I'm gonna use my eyedropper tool, select the blue, and wow, that has an 11.6 to 1 ratio. Let's test the green out, and it has an 8.2 to 1. So just because you can pick a color from Microsoft Word does not mean that it is going to be accessible. And this is where the benefit of using a checklist comes into play, because you can really determine like the specifics that need to happen in order to make your document accessible. And in this case, you want a ratio of 4.5 to 1. The checklist can be downloaded from the link in the description. And if you found this video helpful, please take a second to hit that like and subscribe button. Now on to the next one.